Ah, this looks like a good place for my inaugural video in the Sea of Thieves. what is that? God, it's an awful smell. It's everywhere. What the fuck? My name is Pleb Hummingus, and I have traveled the long seas in search for the most devilish and dangerous plant life around the world. And my travels have brought me to the notorious area known as the Sea of Thieves, where wildlife is abundant, unknown, and ready for me to prong and pick away at it. So sit back, lower your anchors, and prepare to be stupefied in today's episode of Sea of Botany. Welcome everyone to our very first Sea of Botany video in the ever-growing and highly volatile Sea of Thieves. For today's episode, I decided to sail over to a small yet not so large island called Sailor's Bounty. Sailor's Bounty houses many small islands with a large husk of land in the center, which hides a very deep and colossal cave system, but we'll cover that soon. First, the one thing you notice about Sailor's Bounty as you sail closer to it are the fiery red plants sprouted out throughout the land. These are the Bagliosia. They may appear as if they are going through a transition from summer to autumn, but the appearance of the red tinge remains on them throughout their life cycle. The redder the plant, the more mature they are. This plant also seems to grow in abundance throughout the Sea of Thieves, but without actually getting a first-hand approach to these on another island, I cannot guarantee that these are the same ones. But the ones on Sailor's Bounty have a special ability that many may find surprising. They fought as a defense mechanism, and holy hell does it ever smell bad! Imagine having rotten eggs combined with some expired milk, and mix those together using Bigfoot's dick.
Oh my!
And that's the smell you get! It's legitimately the worst thing ever! But what's unique to the smell is that you also get the sense of intoxication once the aroma hits you. It's another defense mechanism to stumble the prey and force them to keep a distance from that smelly dicked plant. Seriously, worst smell ever. I'd rather smell a pig's behind. As I progressed along the sea, there was another small little plant that caught my eye, and I would later find out that these were splattered all over the islands, and they are the Mimbies. Just like that elderly person you punched in the tavern for looking at you in an odd way, these are very harmless plants. The Mimbies really have nothing to distinguish them other than the small blue coloring they portray. In addition, they are also a part of the vine family as they grow outwards and bloom on the arms of the vines as they continue to expand. Like a cute virus spreading little blue blemishes ready to pop on our faces. Not much to say about the Mimbies, though they appear to be more general and universal plants growing in the Sea of Thieves islands, and can be found on several islands and outposts. Again, without first-hand experience, that's only an assumption, because I assume, as I am a assumer. As my search continued, I had almost given up on Sailor's Bounty, thinking that it was only consisted of the Mimbies and the Bagliosia. That is, until I found the secret caves. I didn't know what to expect within these darkly lit caves. Obviously, plants could not thrive in darkness, and it didn't really match the text I have read, because I am an educated man, and no one understands me. But my whore. But what I found surprised me! And my whore. Now, this is not a part of the plant family, but more of the fungi family. More noticeable, an edible fungi family referred to as the Agaricus bisporus, or as these little shrooms like to be called, the Blue Dimple. The Blue Dimple is a mystical mushroom, leaving a light blue glow under the darkness of Sailor's Bounty. It thrived in the dark and can grow up 2.5 to 3 feet tall. The shroom is edible, but you must know how to eat it and when to consume the shroom, otherwise you'll be left like this poor fool who obviously has seen better days. Seriously, he either died from consuming the Blue Dimple or the smell of the Bagliosia. We have no clue. Either or would suck. To consume this shroom, the Blue Dimple must be fully grown and develop a small dimple at the top as you can see here. Once the plant is cut, the glow will faint, but if it's still glowing, you can eat it. If it stops glowing, don't eat it. Otherwise, you literally are vomiting your insides out. Right, Mr. Bone? Okay. It is surprising to find the Blue Dimple here as the fungi are more accustomed to a colder and saltier climate. But this is Sea of Thieves after all, so salt is in abundance. After my search was completed, I will say that Sailor's Bounty has opened my eyes to the capabilities that Sea of Thieves has to offer, and the potential for the range of plant life out there, and I cannot wait to see what else is to come. So until next time, remember to sheathe those swords, holster those guns, and sit and smell the flowers, you angry bastards.
Ah, fuck.